Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good day, metal traders. Ira Epstein with your metals market update. And this is for Tuesday, the 15th of May, 2018 at 4:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Now, before I get going at all, we're going to have my live webinar. And let me see if I can get this going for you. Right there. There it is. And the live webinar is going to be on Thursday, the 17th at 12:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. If you'd like to join, I'm pointing right up here. If you're watching me on YouTube, click this link up there and away you go. For those of you that just want to go about it a different way, it's www.iraepstein.com/webinar. What I'm giving you is the address, and this link gets you signed up. Then a confirmation email will come out to you. On that confirmation email will be the password that you need. The link when I start the webinar, just come on in. I'll try to open it around 12:15 or so Central Daylight Time. You can all get settled in so you can just come in when you're ready. It's first come, first serve, and there's a limited amount of seating. And yes, it is free to attend the live webinar. All right, so let's talk. Today, the event of the day, in my opinion, was kicking up the 10-year yield to just about 3.1%. New high for years that we've seen on this. That did in the stock market, took down the metals, kicked up the dollar dramatically. I frankly don't understand what suddenly got into the market to kick those rates up. I know a lot of people have talked about consumer spending this morning, but when you looked at the numbers, they came in either as expected or slightly under if you looked at the X auto. Admittedly, they did kick up March 0.2%, but the market just seemed to get going. And once you get over that 3% number on a yield, the market's got to adjust to it. Now, you would think the stock market's falling apart the way the TV analysts were talking today. No, that's not the case. The S&P and the Dow are both down for the year. The NASDAQ and Russell are up for the year, and nothing even close to being material. It's a lot of nothing. The markets that are getting hit are your metal markets because the dollar keeps going higher and the Fed keeps talking of getting more aggressive, and that takes out any whiff of inflation out of the economy. It doesn't necessarily stop the commodity move, but people start thinking, well, a higher dollar, goods that are priced in it might get hurt. Makes sense. In the gold, you've gone from 1353 down to the 1290. Now, you know, I do a lot of work on price counts, and you hit a second price count today. For those of you that get our charts of the day, you already saw that this morning. Will you reach to the third, which is in the 1250 area, is now the question. That's how I'm viewing it. You can see how this market consolidated. In fact, let's take off today's action and just take you through yesterday. You were playing around in this area, nothing big, and today you just broke through everything. And that break came in a funny way because you have a higher high, lower low pattern. So it's got people caught. If you get my morning commentary, and I remember I write two commentaries a day, I was pointing out that in the month of April, about $3 billion went into the ETFs to trade the gold market, according to, I think it was MarketWatch or one of those sources. Those people are underwater. This market is now taking everybody that has bought this market. These are new lows for the year. So for the year, anyone in gold that's holding on is down. The market failed against the 18-day average of closes. The 200-day is here. We were not even able to get back to the 100. Literally, all the biases are down in this market. You're under the lower Bollinger Band, and you only stay under that 5% of the time. So I think the market's getting a bit extended and you're already into oversold territory. I consider any move under 30 on the oscillator called slow stochastics to be oversold. Doesn't mean it can't go lower, but if you want to bet against Bollinger Bands, I wish you the best. I'll generally take the other side of that bet. When we take a look at the GLD, and this is what I was talking about. You have a market that failed here against both the 18 and the 100-day average. 2 days ago and right back under the lower band. And like the gold market, you're now oversold because you have a reading under 30. In GDX, you went right to the lower Bollinger band, grabbed some footing. But unlike the other indices, this is not an oversold one. Like the others, it's not trending either. You've got that clear pattern of higher high, lower low, in sideways action. This is the kind of market that can spin around on you, do whatever it wants. The problem is, other than gold getting cheap, why should gold go up? And that's the problem you have. The gold-silver ratio bounced back from the low of 79.20 that it's recently made to 79.68. Remember, up here it was 82.5. So it's given back a chunk, and we'll see what goes on with that. In the silver market, you took out the from the high to the low. So no pattern. You have not had a pattern that you can count on in silver, actually, since right back here, since about mid-April. It's just been whipping back and forth. It keeps failing against key averages. This is the 200-day that I'm pointing at. This is a Bollinger band right there. The 100's in the green. The red is the 18. The market has nothing going for it. Doesn't want to reach for the lower band. It could at the 1610 level. In the copper market, the Chinese delegation is in the United States talking, supposedly, with our trade delegation. I've heard nothing on the news wires about it, and I've been looking for it. And the market, remember, copper is what I call Dr. Copper. It gives you an idea how the economies feel. I wrote this morning showing how the Chinese economy productivity was doing, and while it's a good number, it fell from last month. So the number is getting behind. The April number was behind the March number. We'll see if the Chinese keep consuming the copper. At this point, there's no tariffs on. Will there be is going to be the big question. And if there is, do you think copper can withstand that? I have my doubts. Again, platinum. How do you trade these metals when you don't know if there's going to be all the demand because of all the tariff possibilities that can happen? You've got a higher high, lower low, no trend there. Palladium is still in an uptrend. Higher lows, higher highs. And what a ride this market had today. Look at this range. That's a big range. I mean, when you're a trader in this, that's a big number. The market did hold the 18-day average. The trend is up. However, you are very overbought in this market. That's the strongest of the metals. In the dollar index, I didn't see this coming. I saw the market lose its embedded reading. Normally, I'm looking for price and the 18-day average to come together when that happens. And instead, the dollar popped right on up. It is overbought. It's not embedding. It's a hard market to want to buy on this type of rally. I'm not saying you shouldn't, but I'm just saying what it is. But we're going to talk about all that, and we're going to do it in the webinar, as you know. Remember, you can click up here at any point. That'll get you signed up ahead of time. Do so, and we'll see you on Thursday. I'll talk about this again tomorrow. You already, in your junk mail, your clutter box, or your email, I never know where my emails are going in half of these things. There was an invite sent out today, probably Chicago time, about 11:30 or so. Have a great day. Thanks for watching.